Fort St. James was established in 1806 by the Northwest Company, and it was here primarily because of the water routes. So the water routes were the highways then. It's the largest group of original wooden buildings representing the fur trade in Canada. So it's unique that way, and then the architecture tells the story of the people who lived here.
Fort St. James is an incredible venue. To look around and see the buildings, you know, it's so evident that a lot of care and a lot of love has gone into preserving this place. And when people come here, I think they just feel that.
When you come to Fort St. James National Historic Site, you go out on site, and in each building is a costumed interpreter. And those interpreters all talk about the history of the site.
But who are we talking about here?
The site had for a long time done quite a good job of incorporating the Carrier First Nations story, but if you think of the story as just being one of Euro-Canadian newcomers and local First Nations, you really miss a huge part of what was going on there. There were so many Métis people who worked at Fort St. James in its history as a fur trade fort.
Fort St. James was mainly Métis people in 1896. That's who operated Fort St. James. In fact, A.C. Murray was the chief factor here in 1896.
My ancestors came to Fort St. James in the early 1800s, and this is where we originated in British Columbia.
It's only the last couple of years that they've actually recognized that the Métis people played a significant role in this area.
It's very important that Parks Canada honors all the people that were part of the story. In 1896, Fort St. James had quite recently undergone a major reconstruction. The foreman of that reconstruction was Alexander Campbell Murray.
He was raised at Fort Garry, and he went to St. Jean's College in the Red River Settlement. And in 1867, he joined the Hudson's Bay Company, and they sent him west right away. He didn't hang around, and he came here. He came to this area.
A.C. Murray didn't identify himself as Métis. He identified as a Scot.
He didn't dwell on that aspect of his lineage. He just rolled his sleeves up and got the job done.
A.C. Murray rebuilt the post in the 1880s. And inside the fur warehouse, you can see the meticulous work that he did. He actually hand-planed the ceiling boards in a warehouse.
I can imagine. They brought the trees from across the lake and start building it. And these trees are all hewed by hand. There was quite a few Métis that helped build the buildings.
Some local Métis groups had approached the site and asked why there wasn't more Métis content. We were able to get more funding to do a bigger exhibit that would incorporate Métis themes as they should be at the site.
We started that winter on the display room, and during that time, while we're starting to build, we also met with the local New Caledonia Métis people and people from Prince George.
Most visible when you walk in the room is probably the family photo wall that has photographs of A.C. Murray, his wife Mary Bird, and his daughter Annie Murray, and some of their relatives. And we also have some Métis artifacts.
When we chose the artifacts for the site, we had Métis people choosing artifacts that they felt represented them.
I always love going to Fort St. James. Everyone I've encountered there has just been so nice and so passionate about the site. The Nicosley Elders Society has been a long-time collaborative partner of the site. There's no way that we could have done this project without the Nicosley and Métis advisory groups.
I think something that Parks Canada is doing really well is that they're allowing the Métis to tell their own story.
My grandmother was born here in 1896. She loved Fort St. James. And she often talked about the sunsets here and how beautiful it was. I learned from her it's important to retain the knowledge you have about your family and pass it on. So I do that with my grandkids. I tell my grandchildren, our ancestors were some of the earliest pioneers in British Columbia. We should be proud of that.
Connecting people to this place this land that we're on. I think that that's just really important. It just makes for a healthier community. Mm-hmm.